Hello and welcome to all the viewers. Today our subject of discussion is accountancy, and we are going to deal with the chapter Fundamentals of Partnership, chapter 1 of 12th class. Stay with me, learn with me. I am Preeti Sharma, and find out what we are going to deal with today. The topic of today is interest on drawing. But before coming to the topic, it is necessary to understand the meaning of drawing. What is drawing? Whenever goods or cash withdrawn by the partner for his or her personal use, that is called drawing. Now there are different ways of drawing. First, drawings can be made against profit. Secondly, drawings can be made against capital. So first of all, we will discuss drawings against profit. What is drawings against profit? Drawings against profit are temporary in nature. Decrease in capital due to such drawings are temporary in nature. Interest on drawing can be calculated in two ways. First, equal drawings. Second, unequal drawings. First of all, we will discuss equal drawings. What is equal drawings? Equal drawing means whenever amount is withdrawn, it will be fixed. For example, if 1000 is drawn in the month of January, so 1000 in the month of February, 1000 in the March, 1000 in the April, and so on. So equal drawing means fixed amount will be withdrawn every time. Second, unequal drawings. What is unequal drawings? For example, in the month of January, we are withdrawing 1000. In the month of February, we are drawing 2000. In the month of March, we are not drawing anything. So under unequal drawings, there is no fixed amount withdrawn every time. First of all, we will focus on the various cases of equal drawings. First case, monthly drawings, means whenever drawing is made, it will be of fixed amount from the January up to December. If 1000 is withdrawn in the month of January, so 1000 will be withdrawn in the month of February, and so on up to the December. Now under this case, there are again three cases. First, whenever monthly drawings are made, it can be at the beginning of month, it can be at the middle of the month, and it can be at the end of the month. First, when we are talking about the beginning of the month, that means first drawing is made on the 1st January, second drawing is made on 1st February, third drawing is made 1st March, and so on up to the December. So the formula is total drawing into rate upon 100 into 6.5 divided by 12. Total drawing means if we are drawing 1000 in the month of January, for the whole year drawing will be 12000 into rate upon 100. Rate will be given in the question, and thirdly, 6.5 by 12 is the average period. Now the second is at the middle of the month. When we are talking about the middle of the month, that means first drawings are made on 15 January, second on 15 February, third on 15th March, and so on up to the December. The formula will be total drawing. Total drawing will be 12000 into rate upon 100 into 6 by 12, that is the average period. Third, at the end of the month. If for the 12 months drawing are made at the end of the month, that means first drawing on 31st January, then 28th February, then 31st March, and up to December. Formula will be total drawing. If 1000 is withdrawn, then for the whole year it will be 12000 into rate upon 100. Rate will be given in the question, and the average period is 5.5 divided by 12. Now I am using the term average period. What is average period? The formula of calculating average period is time left after first drawing plus time left after last drawing divided by 2. Now we move to the second case of equal drawing, quarterly drawings. So if one quarter drawing is given, then first of all we have to convert it for the whole year. If one quarter drawing is 1000, so for the whole year it will be into 4, that is 4000. Now there are again three formulas. First, at the beginning of the quarter, at the middle of the quarter, and at the end of the quarter. Formula will be same. Total drawings, that is if for the first quarter drawing is 1000, then for the whole year it will be 4000 into rate upon 100, rate will be given in the question, into 7.5 by 12, that is the average period. At the middle of the quarter, formula will be total drawing into rate upon 100 into average period, that is 6 by 12. At the end of the quarter, formula will be total drawing into rate upon 100 into 4.5 by 12. Average period again will be calculated in the same way, time left after first drawing plus time left after last drawing divided by 2. Now let us move to the last case of equal drawing, that is every month up to 6 months. That means drawings are made only for 6 months, that is 1 to 6 months, and these 6 months can be any month during the year. It can be from January to July or any other 6 months. If drawing amount is 1000 for 1 month, so for 6 months it will be 6000. Formula again, at the beginning of month, at the middle of the month and at the end of the month. For the beginning, again total drawing will be calculated into rate upon 100, this will be given in the question, into 3.5 by 12. At the middle of the month, formula will be total drawing into rate upon 100 into 3 by 12. And at the end of the month, total drawing into rate upon 100 into 2.5 by 12. So these were the cases of equal drawings. Now we can go for certain questions through which you can understand these formulas easily. It was written, Mr. Sachin, a partner withdraws 2000 per month under the partnership deed, interest to be charged at the rate of 18% per annum. If Sachin is withdrawing 2000 per month, then for the whole year he will withdraw 24000, then rate upon 100, that is 18 upon 100 into 6.5 by 12, that is the formula of beginning of the month. In the middle of the month, total drawing again will be 24000, rate is 18 upon 100 and average period is 6 by 12, and last, in the end of the month, 24000 into 18 by 100 into 5.5 by 12. This is how we will calculate interest on drawing. Again, you can see the next question. Mr. Sachin, a partner, withdraws 2400 each quarter. Under the partnership deed, interest to be charged 10% per annum. Calculate interest on drawing in the beginning of each quarter, in the middle of each quarter, at the end of each quarter. If Sachin is withdrawing 2400 in one quarter, that means for the whole year, he will withdraw 9600, that you can see in the solution. Total drawing will be 9600 in all the cases. Then rate will be same for all the cases. Then average period will be different according to beginning, middle and end. This is how you will calculate interest on drawing for each quarter. Next question. Mr. Sachin withdraws 1000 every month up to 6 months. This is a case of 6 months. If he is drawing 1000 in 1 month, then how much he will withdraw in 6 months? Obviously 6000. You can see in the solution, 6000 into 10 upon 100 into 3.5 by 12. This is a case of beginning. And in the middle, 6000 into 10 upon 100 into 3 by 12 equals to 150. There is one more thing to remember. You can see in this question, sometimes it is given the rate, that is 10% or 12% or 15%, but it is not written per annum. Then we will not consider the average period. We will simply calculate the drawing as is shown in the example. Last question, Mr. Sachin withdraws 12,000 during the year. Calculate IOD 10% per annum. Sometimes it is also not mentioned in the question whether it is a beginning, middle or end. Then we will always assume the case of middle of the month. That is why in the solution we have used the average period of 6 by 12. This is the case of equal drawings. Now we move to the unequal drawings. You can see in the example, suppose first drawing is made on 1st February, that is 2000, on 31st May 1000, on 1st July 2000, 31st October 1000, 31st December 5000. You can see this is unequal drawings. How we will solve this question? First of all, we have to calculate number of months up to 31st December or last date of the year or the financial year. So from 1st February to 31st December, there will be 11 months. From 31st May to 31st December, 7 months. From 1st July to 31st December, 6 months. From 31st October to 31st December, 2 months. And from 31st December to 31st December, 0 months. Now we will calculate the product. We will multiply the column 2nd and 3rd. 2000 into 11, 22,000. 1000 into 7, 7000. 2000 into 6, 12,000. 1000 into 2, 2000. 5000 into 0, 0. That is how we will calculate product. That will be 43,000. Now we will calculate interest on drawing. That is, total drawing is 43,000. Suppose rate is given 10%. And in this question, or in unequal drawings, we will always consider the average period is 1/12. So this was about the equal drawings and unequal drawings, and these were the cases of drawing against profits. Now we move to the next point, that is drawings against capital. When drawings are made against capital, there is no interest calculated on these drawings. So today we have discussed various cases of calculating interest on drawing through equal drawings or unequal drawings. Hope you must have understood the topic. Thank you. Have a nice day.